Welcome to the Blessed Mindset Matters podcast. I'm your host, Dr. Raquel Tolson, and we are here on WYTV7, where we educate, we empower, and we encourage. Now, if you've been listening and you have been educated, empowered, and encouraged, I need you to do me a favor. Go to the website, www.wytv7.org. Hit the green donate button. Now you can donate $5 or you can donate $50. Whatever you want to do, we would be most grateful to you. What we use that for is to keep our podcast on the air. And we also send kids to college and we feed families, and not just at Thanksgiving time. So go donate for me. And it is a tax deduction. We are in tax time and you always need to think about those things, especially you business owners out there. So call me if you want to be a sponsor and we can, you know, help you with your taxes. All right. So we have been talking about home ownership all month. We are wrapping it up. I have brought my cousin, Angela Drake, to talk with us. She is in the Midwest. And in the Midwest, so we're not going to just talk about buying your own home. We're going to talk about investing in real estate, in land, and things like that. So thank you, Angie, for being here. Welcome to the Blessed Podcast.
Thank you, Raquel, for having me. I appreciate this opportunity.
I am so excited. We're going to get right into it. So Angie is a real estate agent, and she works with Keller Williams. So before we get into real estate investments, I do want to stop and talk about Keller Williams, because I don't know if we really brought it out, but the other two real estate professionals that we brought on this month, they were all with Keller Williams. Angie, tell us why there are so many people with Keller Williams.
Well, Raquel, so many people have came to Keller Williams because we have some of the best real estate training out here in the industry, hands down. I mean, if you come to Keller Williams and you get the training, you can take that training and go anywhere. You can take it and start your own company, but that training is all about mindset. You know, that it prepares you to have a different mindset, to know that you can do anything in this industry that you want to do. You can accomplish anything. And one of the cool things about Keller Williams is we have what is called profit sharing. So profit sharing is where if we talk with another person and they want to become an agent and we bring them in, you have to be invited. So it's invitation only. So once you are invited to come into Keller Williams, then that person goes under your profit sharing. So which means every deal that they sell, that profit share comes to you. It's a certain percentage based upon how much, you know, the property is that they sell, and you get profit share. You can get a profit share check monthly. It just depends on how many people are selling up under you, how often they're selling, if they're doing, you know, sales monthly, whatever. You know, there's a lady at my office, her profit share check is 10,000 plus a month.
Wow.
Yes. And this is money that you have did nothing for. You haven't went out and sold anything. You've did nothing for, but it's all about the people that you bring in up under you. So there are some really great opportunities that are available at Keller Williams.
That sounds, first of all, you know, you had me when you said mindset, that you guys teach mindset over there, because I'm all about mindset. So that was like, woo woo for Keller Williams.
Yes.
But then, you know, so what you are describing is what people do when they have a broker's license. They hire realtors up under them because they have a broker's license and the broker gets that. But it sounds like Keller Williams is offering real estate agents who may not be brokers that opportunity to bring in people and kind of get that fee that brokers are usually, you know, in the old system, only brokers, real estate brokers, could get that money. You had to have, like, basically have your own agency and hire these people out to be your agents. So it sounds like what Keller Williams is doing, they're allowing people who have a real estate license and not a broker's license to get a piece of that pie, which is just makes sense. And like I try to tell people, I know we're going to get off the subject a little bit, y'all, but bear with me, because I tell people this is why I like network marketing. Because when you're in when you're in corporate America, you can bring people to the job. They're not giving you nothing when those people work and do stuff. But in like network marketing, if you bring people to a job, they're going to give you some money off that person. Now, the person is not paying you for that. The company is paying you for bringing in those people because that's helping the company grow, you know, financially. It's the same thing with it as an insurance person. As an agent, I don't have to be the broker. I don't have to be in, you know, own the agency. As an insurance agent, if I bring somebody to the company and say, hey, and they're going to talk to people and bring them and sell life insurance, that company is going to give me some money too. I am at the point now, Angie, I don't want to work for nobody that's not going to give me a piece of something that I'm bringing in.
That's right.
And I'm absolutely real, because everybody needs to be making some passive income. We shouldn't be, especially when we get older, we shouldn't have to be out here hustling.
That's right.
To make all this money when all we got to do is share that, you know, share with the, you know, the opportunity with people.
That's
and
it.
And the company give us some money for it. So kudos to Keller Williams out here being, you know, just fair.
Yes.
To real estate agents, real estate professionals. That is awesome. I love it. And I wanted her to share that with you, because we've been talking about home ownership, but you know, being a real estate agent is not a bad profession. I mean, it's a way that you can make money. And if you love looking at homes like I do, and you love helping people, you want to help people get into that, this may be something that you want to think about. And what we're going to talk about today, real estate investment, it's probably good to be educated
yes.
about real estate if you want to get into investment. So we're going to just switch over. Oh, wait, before we switch over, I've been talking about home ownership in these different areas. In St. Louis area, is it better? And we already know the answer. We already know it. But is it better to be an owner or a renter? What's the rental price market look like in St. Louis area?
Well, I'm going to say it's better to be a owner.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because I think no matter where you're at, all the landlords have raised prices for renters.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we can just tell by watching the news from one end of the country to the other end of the country. Every landlord has raised prices, and it's all about the supply and the demand. So right mm-hmm. now we have little supply, but more demand.
Okay.
So it's better to be a owner, but on the flip side, it's so much harder to be an owner right now than it was just 2 years ago.
Mm. Oh, yeah. And because now everybody wants to own. So you got 10 people looking at one piece of property. And so if you don't have tickets to the sports teams, they said in Dallas, people giving tickets to the Dallas Mavericks, they're giving tickets for the Cowboys to get the house.
I mean, it is so crazy. And it's all about what your state allows under mm-hmm. that real estate commission. You know, but it's so crazy. I mean, one of my clients, I wrote an offer for them. There were 24 offers that came in this one house. And it's like, how do you decide out of 24 offers who to pick? It's so hard.
Yeah, yeah. But let me just, it is very difficult, but let me just share you guys, even though I bought my house when it wasn't so crazy, but in LA, it's kind of crazy all the time. And then the kind of property I got, because I got a duplex, two houses on one piece of property, those kind of properties, I think probably all over America, those like are sought after properties because you can live in it and rent it, and you only have to, you know, do one mortgage. But let me share with y'all, The reason why I knew that was house was for me, not one other person put an offer on a house. Even in 2016, that's unheard of. Because right. I wanted to put an offer on a condo, 20 people had put an offer. This, and my duplex, not one other person put an offer on that. It was meant for me. So I'm telling everybody out there, what God has for you is for you. It could be 20 people and you're going to be the one to get it if it's for you. Or God can make it where nobody else saw it.
That's right.
And it's for you. So don't be discouraged. I am a living witness. You just have to keep looking for the thing that is for you.
Yes.
Okay, so we already knew that it was better, but it's good to know that it's everywhere. It's not just like, even in the Midwest, the prices of rent are just going sky high. You know, that's what used to keep people out of LA. They say, oh, the rent's too high. Now, Atlanta and St. Louis and, you know, Texas, everybody, the rents are getting higher. So it is imperative that we start thinking about home ownership and getting our own. Now, we're talking about, well, we're going to talk, especially when we come back from the break, we're going to really just talk about investment. But before we go, because people are probably like, well, if it's so hard, how am I, and people don't, when you're telling people not to rent, why am I going to invest in property and then nobody going to want to rent? Well, you don't just have to invest in properties that people rent. Think about that. You don't, because people think about investments, they only think about, oh, well, I got to buy this house and rent it out.
No.
No. People, you can buy the house and sell it. You can flip it. You can buy land and develop it. I mean, so there's a lot of things. And so Angie, when we come back, Angie's going to talk about some of the things that you can do. And I mean, listen, real estate, when people used to, they say real estate is king. Isn't that what they say? I think it's something like that. Real estate is king. Well, I'm going to go, or some people say, no, it's cash is king. But, you know, I don't agree with that because, you know, money is just a tool to get the things that you want. And real estate is a thing that we want. And so I'm going to say that real estate really is king because we want to set ourselves up where we have property because you just never know what's going to happen. If you got some property, you can grow some food. You can get you a cow. You know what I'm saying? So you can have some milk. I'm just saying, y'all, we gotta think about these kind of things. So we're going to take a quick break. We're doing it a little early because I want to get back and I really want to talk about investing in real estate when we get back. So do not go away. Come back. I'm Dr. Raquel Tolson, host of Blessed Mindset Matters. Is your mind on your money? Are you ready to be more intentional with your money? Then get my free booklet, Mind on My Money, Plan, Pocket, Protect. In this booklet, I offer you practical suggestions on planning intentionally, pocketing wisely, and protecting your money. Get the booklet at www.raykeltolson.com. That's RAYKELTOLSON. Get your free copy today. We are back with Angie, my cousin, Angela Drake, Keller Williams, real estate professional, and we are ready to talk about real estate investment. So Angie, tell us what you're doing.
So I have into developing.
Okay, you've entered developing?
Yes, so I'm now developing properties. So basically, it's like flipping properties. So basically, I have started getting properties, we're doing the construction on it, and then we're gonna put it up for sale. You know, I love selling people homes. I love educating people on homes, but what better way to help create a better supply of homes? take a home and renovate it and create a new home for someone out here. A lot of times when you get out here and you renovate a home, when you take it down to the studs, you're basically creating a brand new home for someone. And that's one of the things that I'm doing out here.
Okay, so, and that's because, you know, and it's really interesting that you say that, because you said you're developing or you're fixing it up. So you're building it from the ground, or you're taking one that has to be gutted and redoing it. Because most people, they see those homes and they don't see any value in it. Yeah. And then some people may not be able to do it, or they don't have the people to fix up the houses for them. So they need somebody like you to go in there and make it where it's moving and ready, and they can just, you know, just put in their furniture and they're ready to go. So what made you decide to do that, other than, you know, you knew that the market, it wasn't enough homes, so you decided you wanted to, provide some homes. But what else made you do that?
Well, Raquel, I remember telling my grandmother, who was your Aunt Ernestine, you know, long time ago, I remember telling her that I loved homes. And I could look at a home and just envision what it could be. And so having that passion of, you could take anything and turn it into something so beautiful, that just created and made my passion even deeper of, this is something that I could do. This is something that could be a legacy for me. This is something that can create generational wealth for me, my children, and my grandchildren. Mm-hmm. So, you know, out of all of that, that created this fire in me to say, hey, I'm going to get some homes. I'm going to do a total renovation. And then I'm going to create something that we call turnkey ready for mm-hmm. someone. You know, I have a home that is a small, it's about 700 and something square foot home. And we are going to take it's a small pitch roof. So we're going to take that off. We're going to create a second story on this house and create a full 3-bedroom, 2-bathroom, 1400 square feet. So we're going to add like an additional 700 square feet onto this house, but it's going to be turnkey ready. And it's going to be something that somebody can come in and just set their toothbrush in the bathroom and they will be ready to live in it.
Yes, that sounds beautiful. That sounds beautiful. And I'm just thinking about it. Like, why did you decide to do, like, to sell the houses as opposed to rent them? Like, why didn't you want to be a landlord?
Well, actually, I am a landlord.
Oh, okay.
So I am both. So okay. There are certain homes that I look at that automatically it comes to me, hey, I'll use this particular house as something I'll renovate and resell. And there are some homes that are out here that I look and say, you know what, I'm going to renovate this and put a tenant in. So it's just kind of like whatever comes to me first when I look at the home, and what kind of feeling that I get, you know, should I sell it or should I put a tenant in here? So, you know, I just kind of decide when I, you know, come upon a home.
That's awesome. Let me tell y'all, being a landlord, I did it for a long time. And then this this situation where they were telling people they ain't got to pay rent. Oh, the government messed us up over that, because you have people who could pay rent and just decided, oh, the government say I don't have to pay rent. I was like, oh, the government. I got issues with the government right about now. So I just decided, my tenant, they decided to leave. And I was like, you know, I'm. So now my only tenant is my son. And the only reason why I'm renting to him, y'all, because he gonna pay his rent. Let me tell you why he gonna pay his rent. And yes, I charge my child rent. We live in LA. So I'm not gonna even tell y'all how much his rent is, because y'all probably gonna be like, oh, that's horrible that you charge your child so much. But let me tell you why I charge him that much rent. Because it's not like he's out here paying rent to some stranger. He is making an investment in his future, because this house is going to be his. This is going to be his house. So he's basically just making sure that everything is good. So when he gets the house, it's gonna be worth a whole lot more than what he owe on it.
Yes.
So don't be sending me messages talking about you and me, mama. No, I'm a smart mom. My son is investing in his future.
That's right. And
Yeah,
also,
but
I started teaching my youngest son about, renovating homes and having, a certain stock of homes as rental property. So that way, when I get to be older, this is something that he can take and he can move in the direction that he wants to move it in. But I've created that legacy for him.
Yes, you have. That is awesome. And let me just say out there, guys, I mean, if you buying real estate, being landlords or flipping houses, we know it's not easy. We know it's not easy. That's why you have real estate professionals. I'm going to make sure Angie's information is there. That's why you have people like Keller Williams is teaching you how to do this stuff because you need to learn about it. But tell me, Angie, where should the people now? Y'all know you can do all things, but I'm gonna tell y'all, we live in LA. I'm not trying to invest in LA right now. I want no, and I'm not even investing right now, but my son is like, okay, go to the South, find areas where it's gonna be up and coming, where it's still fairly inexpensive to invest in homes or land. So would you say that the Midwest is actually a really good place to invest?
I think it's a great place to invest. I would say the Midwest, probably to down south. I think those are some great places to invest because, like you say, there's a lot of land. There is a lot of opportunity there. I think it's all about learning, where you want to invest at, and then start studying their market first, and learning more about, what their prices are, what they pay in rent, what that neighborhood home sells for, and what a as is property sales for there. And just kind of start doing your homework to teach you, and then you can make your move and start investing. But the Midwest is a great place to invest.
I've heard Detroit, some people wouldn't call Detroit the Midwest, but I kind of think of it as the Midwest. I guess because we used to drive up there for family all the time. But Detroit area is, I heard was really good. But one of the places that I've heard, and I keep hearing it, is Memphis.
I
Now,
started
Nashville, let me tell y'all, Nashville is like a little LA. Oh, it's too late if you haven't already gotten to
That's
Nashville.
right.
But Memphis is the area I'm hearing that it's a really great opportunity to buy up some property and to invest in real estate there.
Yeah, I've started hearing that. I've also, started to see Bentonville, Arkansas,
Really?
yes, has started to really just kind of kick up. I've heard about Alabama. They started, having a lot going on there. Mississippi has started having a lot going on. So, yeah, I mean,
I actually heard about Mississippi too. Somebody told me
yeah.
because they were saying because they say you need to go down to Mississippi and buy up some property and build your publishing so you can start publishing books. I was like, wait a minute, what? It was like, leave California, go to Mississippi, and then start. I was just like, wait a minute, I'm not even trying to do all of that. But they were saying Mississippi is a really good place. And then I'm just gonna be honest. When I think of certain places like a Mississippi, I'm just thinking, me, this little black girl, do I really want to be down in Mississippi? But I've been told that we might want to rethink the South.
Yeah,
We might want to
it's
rethink the South.
definitely an opportunity to think about. The South holds a special place in my heart. My grandfather was from Mississippi, and all of his siblings. So, I love it when I go. A lot of people are like, oh my gosh, it's so hot, but
It
it has great opportunity. It does.
is. I mean, it's really interesting when we think about investing in real estate and things like that. And most people, when they think about real estate, they're only thinking about buying a house. Or, you know, possibly buying a house to rent, you know, rent to people. But they're also shopping, like not shopping centers, but you know, little strip malls.
Yes.
That is a good opportunity because the strip malls, especially if you get an area, an up and coming area where you know they're gonna need a Starbucks, come on, y'all. They're gonna need, or
There is
if some kind of coffee place, you know, or they're gonna need a nail shop. You know, they're gonna all, when you build these new homes, they need places. And so if you're buying up the land, even if you sell it to the Starbucks people, if you sell it to the people that the gas station people, but you will make that profit because you have bought that land around the where they're building up houses and schools and things like that. So that's another thing to think about is just buying some property and holding it until somebody want to buy it from you.
That's fantastic you say that, Raquel, because let me share something with you. Chase Bank has started to come in a lot of urban city and rural areas. They want to get into a lot of these areas. So they are out here looking for land to purchase to put a Chase Bank in a lot of areas that other people wouldn't have thought of, you know, because they're looking to come into the communities. So if you own a piece of land, hey, shoot it out there to them and let them know, I have this piece of land available. You might want to bring a Chase Bank to the neighborhood.
Wow. And that's what I say, the Chase Banks, and we all know Starbucks and those kind of places always trying to get, because they you know have a following. People love them, so they want to put those
Right.
like, so if you're buying the land where they're building up, you can always sell it to those kind of people, or you can create your own little strip mall and let smaller companies come in and capitalize off the new business. Because you know sometimes when you go and move into the when you're young and you have to go outside of a city to be able to afford, you're
Yes.
going out, like especially like in the Texas area, because that it's so big out there. My niece lives in Houston, and so she's outside of Houston, but she was in like it was like a little country, and we had to drive a little ways before we saw, you know, stores. So I'm like, oh, the people that buying the land around here, they're gonna put up little stores so the people don't have to go far.
Because it's all about convenience.
It's all about convenience.
Yes.
Yes. We, oh my gosh, the time has, it is going so fast. Oh, we have been talking about a lot of stuff. So Angie, tell us like in this last few minutes, what should somebody really do? If you told them to look into other cities and find out what the rental ratings are, or like just what's going on, but what else should they be doing? Should they go to class? Should they be what should you do if you want to be a real estate investor?
Well, you could do one of two things. If you want to be an investor, you could also look into getting your real estate license. Keller Williams has a free class that they offer in every state.
A free class.
A free class. And if you want to, you know, take that class, feel free to give me a call, contact me. You can text me, whatever, I'll share my information. But you can reach out and sign up for Keller Williams free real estate class, and they have it in every city. But you
Wow.
can get your license, and that will give you the true ins and out of how to become an investor. Also, Keller Williams has classes in all local cities in that market center that teaches you about being an investor.
Really? So not just to be a realtor, but to be an investor.
Yes, to be an investor. And I
Wow.
mean, just like at my market center, actually, the gentleman that owns my market center is president and CEO of Keller Williams down in Austin, Texas, and his name is Mark King. But Mark hosts a wealth building class with us every single Friday morning. And I'm telling you, he gives us some great ideas on building our wealth. So you get so much more out of Keller Williams than just your average, oh, come be a real estate agent. You get everything. Everything is covered.
Wow. The people that are in the St. Louis area, we're gonna make sure that you find out about this because, hey, you guys need to go over there and check that out. I mean, I might have to come to St. Louis when I come for a weekend. I'm gonna come early so I can be there on that Friday morning so I can come and go to one of those with you because I'm all about financial education. We do our money 101s to teach people more about money. But hey, once you learn about money and you got some money, you need to learn how to make it grow even further and to do even more. So I am excited about that. Thank you so much for coming and joining me. Hey guys, we're starting in April next month. I mean, next week is going to be April, and we're going to find some people to talk to us about taxes and other ways to make money. That's what we started here. Thank you, Angie. Thank you guys for watching. Until next week, be blessed.